Hook shifts to tighten it. Come and draw the first frame pin. Put the back end on the crochet hook. Draw a standing pin after drawing. All three rounds are 6 short pins. Just put a short stitch in each stitch. The first hook is on and the marker is on. Here are 6 short hooks. Draw it long. Turn it over so it faces out. The last stitch of the quilt can be stretched a little longer. Go to the first needle. Cross to draw the line. When the lines come out, first reduce the elongated lead quilt. The first thread can be cut. This is the lead quilt for the first turn. Come and pull it out. Pull and hook a standing pin. Start the second loop. The 6th check will not be drawn. Leave about 30 to 40 centimeters of thread to cut out. 前一个线圈比较松的话, you can pull a coil here. Make it smaller and tighten it. Hook for legs in the same way. All for legs to hook his tail. The tail is first hooked by four braid pins. Hold the loop like this. Draw the thread out and tie it in a slip knot. Then start hooking the braid. The first end doesn't hook inside. The inside of the second tail only wears one side of him. To hook a short needle. Put another short pin in the last one. Hook three short needles. Leave a piece of line to cut. Straight out. This is his tail. And then we're going to assemble them. Sew the legs to the top of the turtle shell. The long thread left on the leg is threaded to the needle. Come through in the third one. Sew the legs in these three. Just go back and forth and there's no fixed number of stitches. Finally, the thread hides a few stitches in the shell. Just put a few stitches down there. When sewing, there's a small gap on the side of the turtle. Put the little notch here facing the shell here. Go over 3x4 stitches to sew the next leg. Sew this side to the third stitch here. When the tail is hooked, it has a natural curve. Turn the curve side down. Just take a look and sew it in the middle. Thread the other thread under it. Then mix the lower shell with the upper shell. Face position. This is the back. Corresponding to the drawing needle on the shell. Start with the first shot. Near the leg, find the thread under the leg and thread it. It's a 1-for-1 stitch up to the side here. When I was about to sew a circle, there's a mouth on the front leg. Put the padded cotton in. Put the cotton on the top and sew the head on. The thread under the head can be cut shorter. Use the green line of the lower shell to sew. Just squeeze in the white thread and get rid of it. Tie the wire that you pulled down to the bottom. We just had 6 inside half pins under last shoe. There are low outer half stitch lines left. And then when you put it on, you put it on the line. Leave the drawing lines directly below and adjust them. Sew to the side under the neck. Put it on here. I can lead to empty needles in the middle. It's the empty needle that goes through here. Finish this and thread it through the empty needle here. Put it on and pull it over. Go under and over here. And this goes through the space. And then the thread goes down first. Let's sew it up. Top with the green thread of the top shell. First, put the thread in the gap of the last loop of the head. Now the shell is going through the side to the side. Put it on the edge of the shell, too. Put it through the gap on the second to last lap. Keep your head up. Make it a raised position. Sew and pull tight, and then go back and forth through the shell. The thread will not run away and cut again. Sew the bottom line too. Cut out about 80 mm of light green thread. Split the thread down the middle. The thread has 4 strands. Split it in two, in two. Two separate strands of thread are threaded to the needle. Tie a knot at the end of the thread on one side. Tie a knot at the end of the thread on one side only. Wait a minute and seal it with this line on one side. To sew the lines on the shell, come through the middle. Slow down when you pull it over. Give him a little turn to the side. Prevent the wire from pulling out. And wear it here and wear it out. Don't pull it too tight. Wear it out and wear it down here. First, sew out the hexagon. Back to this pinhole. Put it in the last pinhole. Second turn. 123 in the gap on the third lap. Through these two, three loops. Find the gap that corresponds to the top. And connect the edges of the second loop. Sew a downward thread on the third turn. Once you're done, thread the thread back and forth through the shell. Cut off any excess. I press into his head 6-7 times. 6 or 7 laps in the middle of the gap. Let's find the symmetrical position. You can start by pressing one of your eyes up. Press in. Let's look at the corresponding place over here. Keep your eyes safe. Sew a mouth with coffee-colored thread. A small strand of dark coffee. Thread it to the needle. Align the ends of the two lines and tie the knot. Put it anywhere on the inside of your head first. Fix the wire. Hitch in. And then back and forth again. So the thread doesn't get pulled out. The mouth can find its own place to sew. From here on to the second circle. Make sure it's in the middle. Put another pin in the middle. Keep it from sticking up. Don't pull it too tight. When you're done, thread the thread back and forth. And then cut it out. The foam cord goes right around his neck. Just thread a few threads.